Hey, it's Steve. Last time we dug and poured the footing. So now we're gonna lay some bricks and blocks for our foundation. In a little while, I'm hoping the brick mason shows up out here and we're gonna get started, but right now I'm doing two things. I am gonna verify the materials that we had delivered out on the job, and I'm also looking at the points of the foundation. Now what's happened is that I've had the surveyor come back out here and he has remarked the corner points of the foundation just like he did previously for the footing. Now the hope is that we dug the footing accurately and these points match on the footing. And I've walked around here and it looks like we did a great job. But if you look right here, here's one of the points right here. And if you can imagine where my hand is where the wall is going to be. It's actually going to turn here and turn back this way. And you can see there's plenty of concrete on either side of it. It's going to run again where my hand is, an 8-inch wall down to this point. This is about where the front door is going to end up being of the house. It'll come here, it'll turn back. Again, we're going to run from this point down to that one, and again, it looks good. Right here, I'm going to have stone veneer from this corner, which is right there, around here, and then around to that corner of the garage. It's going to come back and it's going to wrap right here. So you can lay blocks only.
Black, 8-inch black.
Yeah.
From this corner?
Yeah, all the way around. And see, I wrote block right there on the plan.
Okay.
And then all the way to this corner right here. Now, right here, we need to lay bricks on the front of the porch.
Okay, so all this is stone?
Blocks. Yeah, that's going to have stone on it. Yeah, somewhere in this neighborhood. And I'm going to try to figure out what that is. So we can bury three. Now, I ordered the materials based on that we were using a lot of blocks.
Okay.
Now, I got a materials list out there. Hey, Brian. The fact is, that's probably going to cost a grand, but I don't want to screw the whole thing up over a grand.
So, four courses there puts you what? Five.
That's nine courses. So that's going to be 6 feet exactly, yeah. But only on that last row, and it's getting buried anyway.
One there, one block.
This will bury three. And so
I
that.
I can bury a couple in there.
Well.
You're going to have to get that water out.
Yeah, and you could do more up there, but I'm just saying down here,
yeah.
Three. You know, you might be able to bury two up there. Yeah, two.
One in the front.
Right. Yeah, one up there. You know, maybe you can get back up. You could definitely get back up to burying two or three back up towards the garage too.
I'd bury two courses there.
Yeah, the level part of the yard back here, and then maybe it'll start falling off as it goes underneath the deck and wraps around the house right there. So my brick mason Nick has put this self-leveling laser right here up by the street. It's on one 8-inch block. And it's shooting towards the foundation of the house. And if you look over here, I've got four blocks stacked up on the footing. And right here is a tiny red dot, and that is where the laser's shooting. And what that's telling me is that that point is 8 inches above the street height out there. And that's going to help me decide where I'm going to put the height of this foundation. Now, I've more or less decided that I'm going to go with the top of this block that's below here. I just put this one here so you can see the laser beam. Friday out here, and we're down here at the lower side of the lot, and I want to show you what the repercussions of that little stack of blocks I made with the laser beam the other day is. See how high this has gotten. Now, every time that you lay about 8 inches of block, and in this instance, it probably costs about $1,500. So it's very tempting as a builder to think, I'm just gonna make this foundation as low as I can, work out the driveway in some way that's somewhat acceptable, and keep the cost down. But we are going with our original vision to try to make, you know, a really nice driveway up there and make this site work properly for what it is. Some things that have been going on that I wasn't able to show on camera are that I had to pick these bricks and also some stone that's gonna go with them and get the materials out here for them to lay this foundation. I have been talking with the building material supplier about the framing materials, also the windows that I'm gonna use, and we're gonna talk a little bit more about that when we get more in the framing process. I've also picked the appliances for the job, and I've also finished selecting the cabinets, and all these things affect the movement of the job forward and trying to make sure that we accommodate parts of the house as we proceed. Now, Nick says he thinks that we're gonna finish out here today, but I'm not so sure.
So we gotta finish this in blocks, so we're a little short, and we got the piers, but you got some stacked up in there. You're not gonna finish today anyway, are you?
No, but
Where you can get it?
No, the block.
We can get them somewhere close if you need to just get some.
From Lowe's anyway?
We can if you need to.
Yeah.
Okay, when have they got them? So I was just talking to Nick, and I need to get some more blocks out here, 8-inch blocks. It doesn't seem like any way you've tried to figure out and estimate it that you can get it right, because there's all sorts of stairs and in the footing, and it's really hard to figure out exactly what the materials are in a foundation. Now, I hate over ordering, because then you have a big pile of materials laying around. You can either move them to the next job, or you got to figure out a way to return them or store them somewhere. So, we're more or less finished with the foundation. We got on for an inspection today, and this is where the stairs are going to be. We needed more blocks to finish the stairs. I got to get one more cube of blocks out here, which is about 70 to 90 blocks, depending on where you get it from, to finish these stairs. But that doesn't really matter for the inspection, because they don't really consider that a structural component of the house. Right here, you can see that we've got bricks coming around the corner of the porch, but then right here turns the block, and you might be wondering, well, why does it look that way? And what's gonna happen is there's gonna be a stone veneer put on this part of the foundation. And when it's all finished, it'll make a transition from brick to stone all along here, and it'll run down the front of the garage right there. We'll be right back.
So I want to talk some more about this foundation that we shot with our laser beam.